Hello, I'm Mike with this week's new and trending AI tools you cannot afford to miss. Let's get straight into it. And Perplexity have just killed half the internet. Blogging, Google, ChatGPT, even Wikipedia, potentially killed by this update, Perplexity Pages. So what is Perplexity? Well, it's a question search engine for the internet. Kind of what Google tried to do with their generative search, but they recommended you use glue to get cheese to stick to pizza and eat rocks for your health. Maybe not ideal. So with Perplexity, you can ask it any question such as, how do I get cheese to stick to pizza? And there you go, within moments, it searched the internet, Reddit, other recipe websites, and it's recommending using less sauce, avoiding thickened or slimy sauces, don't overoil, use torn or irregularly cut cheese pieces. No mention of glue anywhere there as far as I can see. Now they've taken this to the next level by allowing you to convert your search into a page that can help others online. And you'll see it's going through and making my page for me, how to make cheese stick to pizza. And it's curated here by me, Mike Russell. I'm the user of Perplexity. And it says cheese sliding off pizza is common and frustrating. And it offers different tips, such as reducing sauce amount. It then offers the sources there to show where it's referenced from, avoiding slippery ingredients, cheese preparation tips, and also crust and cooling techniques as well. Now, this is like writing something on Medium or a WordPress blog, but they seem to have killed most of the internet by allowing you to do it right there with generative AI. While Google can copy the AI search, it can't copy these pages, but it will potentially index these pages, meaning that your curated content could well be discovered. So I can go in and I can make any changes I like. I can drag and reposition this image, but I think it looks quite good. I can even add an image to each section. And look at that, it actually finds an image for me, which I can then change, and I can choose what I'd like to do. Now, as we're talking about sauce, let's select this image, and there you go, reduce sauce amount. Avoid slippery ingredients. Let's add another media. And I've actually done a search here, cheese slipping on pizza. And here we go. This looks quite good. So I can add that in. For the next section, let's use a cheese grater here. That looks really cool. And then we've got crust cooling techniques. So let's add one more piece of media. So this is looking brilliant. My brand new finished page on Perplexity Pages. I can now hit publish, copy the link, and I'll share it down below. Now, if you're enjoying the video so far, do throw a like and also subscribe to the channel as I'm doing weekly updates and more videos that help you learn and get to grips with AI tools. Now, let's not stop there. Let's actually get out of this and start a brand new page. Now, to do this, if you've got the Pro account with Perplexity, you just click plus next to your library and click page. This will give you the opportunity to create a brand new page. And I'm going to say my page is about the best AI tools for video editing. Now, it's given me some very generic sections such as AI-powered color grading, automated multi-camera editing, and AI-driven video transcription and captioning. While those are good, it's not really what I'd recommend, and as I'm knowledgeable in the subject, I'll actually delete these sections right now and start again. So we can just go through and delete everything that was auto-generated by Perplexity and start brand new sections. So for the first section, I'm going to say generative fill for video in Adobe Photoshop. That's something I'd like to put into my article. Next, I want to give a mention to Runway ML, a great AI video editing tool. So I'll go into this section and say Runway ML AI tools for video editing. And finally, if you listen to the Creator Magic podcast earlier this week with Premiere Girl, she mentioned Firecut AI.
Yeah, the one that we use right now is called Firecut to generate our animating captions.
So for the final section, I'll prompt Perplexity Pages Firecut AI for chapters and captions. And there you go. Within moments, I've got a relative article talking about top AI video editing tools, including Photoshop's Generative Video Fill, Runway ML, and Firecut as well. So I'll just click publish. So my question to you is, will Perplexity Pages replace blogs, even maybe reading books and gaining knowledge from places such as Medium, Wikipedia, Google Search, and potentially ChatGPT in the future as well? What do you think? Let me know in the comments down below. Next up, I want to show you a really cool tool that uses AI and machine learning to show you how to be a better YouTuber and make your thumbnails pop out. It was actually created by Mr. Beast, who featured recently on a podcast with John Yushe. It's really, really cool, and I'll link to that show down below in the comments if you want to check the full 1 hour and nearly 30 minutes interviewing Mr. Beast. He drops so much value. I cannot recommend listening to that show enough.
Over the years, I've just built a lot of tools. These are like really good. And it would be kind of cool if other people could use them, especially smaller creators.
It's called ViewStats, and lots of the features are free. You can search any YouTube channel that you like. So I'll search for Mike Russell. There he is. And we can actually look at my channel. Now, this is maybe not different to other tools out there that can find stats and stuff for free. But what makes this tool unique, just the free stuff that's available, is you can actually look at videos that appeared on the channel, click into one, and see, just as the creator would see in their YouTube studio, how that video performed, so whether it was above average, what their estimated revenue is down here, and also how it ranked out of 10 on their recent releases. So you can see, actually, my OpenAI voice scandal video ranked the best, and that is true. It's number one, followed by my Apple just killed royalty-free music. That's number two. AI music, that's number three on my channel. So you can type in any channel on YouTube and find their best videos using ViewStats for free. It's completely insane. Another cool free aspect of ViewStats is the ability to see similar channels. You can click in there and maybe you can even find a few YouTubers that you could collaborate with just by looking here at the similar channels to yours. Now, we know that MrBeast is an incredible creator, and it's great that he's making a tool like this available to creators like you and me. Now, with ViewStats, you can upgrade to the Pro plan, and it gives you some incredible features, including the ability to really dial in your thumbnails. Now, this is important. I was speaking to Nick Nimmin on my Creator Magic podcast a couple of weeks ago.
One of the thumbnails that I'm testing right now is I have MrBeast in there, and I have Ali Abdaal in there. For MrBeast, I changed the color of his shirt.
And he's talking about the importance of adjusting and A/B testing your thumbnails. You can see how MrBeast does it all the time, changing all different aspects of the thumbnail by minute amounts, even the color of the t-shirt, the facial expression, the position of people in the thumbnails. It really is incredible to see what he does. So now I've upgraded, I've got access to five awesome tools, the ability to add alerts, search for outlier videos, which are videos that did exceedingly well on a channel, thumbnail search, A/B test, and collections. Let's start with thumbnail search. It uses machine learning to scan YouTube and find thumbnails matching your description that did well. So I've got a magic wizard casting a spell, and look at that. There are some thumbnails that have done pretty well on YouTube around my theme. Now I can sort, instead of by similarity, by outlier score, which means the video did exceptionally well on the channel, and find different kind of thumbnails that I might like to use. And actually, do you know what? I quite like this thumbnail. I can either click into it and use it myself to iterate and create a thumbnail, or I can do search by thumbnail. And there we go. We've got more suggestions based on the thumbnail I clicked here that I can look through and choose to use. But actually, do you know what? I really like this thumbnail. So I can see straight away how that video did. Now, what's more, I can see all the tests every single YouTube channel have done by clicking Open Gallery. And here for this particular channel, I can see they've made a number of title changes and thumbnail changes here. In fact, they've made a total of 69 changes to this video to optimize it. So because I really like the initial thumbnail, I'm going to use the vidIQ plugin to download that thumbnail and bring it into AI. So I've uploaded the image here and said, describe everything you can see in the image as if you were writing a short, concise text prompt for an AI image generator. And here is my prompt. I can now bring that into Midjourney. So I'm now going ahead, posting that prompt into my Imagine on Midjourney's Discord. I'm adding some tags on the end, a character reference, Cref, so it gets the character close to being me in the image, and then character weight, and of course, the aspect ratio. And within moments, Midjourney has given me a thumbnail that looks exactly like the very high-performing and split-tested thumbnail that MrBeast's ViewStats gave me. I can now use this on my own channel. Now I've gone ahead and run a face swap tool on this to get it even closer to my face, gone from this to this, and now that is ready for me to bring into Photoshop or Adobe Express and edit. If you want to see how I further refine thumbnails for my YouTube channel, go and check out the video on your screen now, or click in the link down below to follow along. I've got a detailed AI thumbnail tutorial right here on the channel. So now I can benefit from the experience of bigger YouTubers who have really good thumbnails that they've split tested, in this case 69 times, to come up with something that's very clickable and works well, and I can get that within seconds using the new tool from MrBeast called ViewStats. Now, it doesn't stop there. There are a few other tools such as outliers. So if I want to search by keyword, maybe AI tools.
So like if a person's getting 1 million views a video and then they upload a video and it gets 5 million views, well, why did that video do 5 times better? Mm. And like, we just give you a collection of videos like that that performed really well, so you can brainstorm based off of it.
I can even go to alerts and create an alert called AI tools. And that way it's going to notify me every time there's a new video that does well on YouTube related to AI tools. I can dial it in and say I want long videos only, and it's got to have at least 10,000 views to qualify for being a good video. The A-B test tool is also a pretty powerful tool. You can benefit from the experience of other big YouTubers, so I can search by channel here. How about Mr. Beast? And now here I can see every thumbnail test that Mr. Beast has done. I can click into this and we can see how he's gone through different thumbnails and different title descriptions on his video until he ended on the one that worked best. So if I want to do a thumbnail with me holding TNT in my mouth in the future, I can ask ChatGPT to describe it, bring that prompt into Midjourney, and create something incredible and similar using AI that's remixed and ready for my audience. So there you go. It's incredible to see Jimmy Donaldson, Mr. Beast, supporting small to medium creators who want to optimize their YouTube content. I really like ViewStats, and I'll be linking to it down below, as I do with every tool. Let me know how you get on with it, and throw a big like if you've enjoyed what you've seen so far. Also, subscribe to the channel. Remember, I have weekly updates just like this. Finally, we'll end with AI music generators. They are not slowing down, and Suno just announced that they're cooking up version 4. We were pretty impressed with version 3, but they've now released version 3.5 in the meantime for all users. What does this mean? Well, you can make 4-minute songs. Let's have a crack at making one now. Create, and I'm going to type in as the description here, a song about magical tools that make life better in every way. I can choose to make it musical or not. Let's just leave it as is. And of course, we're using V3.5, the newest model.
Mystic hammer, magic drill. Life's a game, we play it well. Golden wrench and silver pliers. Fix the dreams that never tire. Wanda stars a shining light. Turn the dark into the bright. Threads of hope in needle's eye. Weave our wishes night and sky. Magic tools in our hands. Fill our castles in. Secrets kept.
Okay, so I really like that song. I'm actually going to go ahead and make it public like so and give it a thumbs up. I'll link it down below if you want to go ahead and listen and thumb up yourself. But version 3.5 of Suno is seeming pretty good, as it was generating my song on the fly all the way up to 4 minutes with just one single prompt like that. That's incredible. Not only that news from Suno, but they're also introducing Make a Song from Any Sound pretty soon. This is incredible. This is a Suno software engineer playing the piano, and you can feed that into the model to get something back that's an accordion that will go along with the piano. So you'll essentially have virtual musicians generated by Suno in the future. Now, not to be outdone by Suno, Udio, the arch rival of Suno, have also come up with some updates this week. Udio 130 is their new model. It allows you to do 2-minute song generations. And you can also control more advanced features such as the prompt strength and also lyric strength. So let's make that higher, which means it will pay more attention to the lyrics that I add. Let's have a listen to the generation from Udio.
Enchanted tools are gleaming. Whisper spells to ease the day. Wands and charms aligning. I feel the magic guide my way.
So there you go. Not only do Udio and Suno both give you more control over your generations, Udio actually now gives you the ability to follow creators on the platform. And if you'd like to follow me, I'll link to my profile down below. And that's it for this week. If you'd like to get my weekly AI tools updates in the form of a quick email newsletter, go ahead and subscribe using the link down below. And I've got videos showing on your screen now. If you want to go down the rabbit hole a little bit more with AI audio and music, go and watch that video. There's also the Creator Magic podcast. And if you're not subscribed to that, I'm having brand new guest creators on every week to talk about how they're using AI tools.